Hey, welcome back to Living Dayton. You know, it's like driving a stick again. I'm finally used to driving the car, and then I'm off the show. That morning cup of joke, now you know what. That morning cup of joke can really get you going, and here to help us dissect the good, and the bad of this coffee is Dr. Rob. Now, should I be on the good side? Natalie, you get on the bad side.
No, we keep this was very intentional. This was very intentional, Boo.
This
we
is hang on out the bad with the side. Devil. Everybody likes their coffee, though. I mean, you know.
They do. And a lot of people like to start their day with coffee. And coffee has a lot of health benefits to it, which is a good thing for coffee drinkers. What do we know? We can't prove it, but we do know that people who drink coffee have a lower incidence of diabetes, lower incidence of stroke, heart arrhythmias, less of the neurocognitive disorders like Parkinson's disease, dementia, and Alzheimer's.
Really?
So those are some pretty solid benefits from drinking coffee. Now, the average American drinks about 1.5 cups a day of coffee. And can you guess where in the United States there's the most coffee shops? What city?
Well, you know, you're going to say like Portland, but
you're getting close.
Really? Is it out Seattle?
Seattle. Oh. Seattle. Which city do you think has the least amount of coffee shops?
I don't know.
Oklahoma City.
Really?
Oh,
yep, least amount of coffee.
So I would not have guessed that.
I don't know. But so when it comes to the health benefits of coffee, there's a lot that we can learn and a lot that we can use in coffee to help benefit our health. We know that caffeine, which is a component of coffee, can help boost metabolic performance and your performance athletically. Mm-hmm. So a lot of athletes like to use it before they do their events. We also know that it can help you lose weight. You see, caffeine can help you release fat from your fat cells so that you can lose weight and get thinner. So there's a lot of benefits. Plus, it can also boost your sexual performance.
Oh, right, that's
the bad side, right?
That's or the good side.
Now, is this across the board, any kind of coffee?
What we're talking about is the caffeine that's in the coffee.
Okay.
Coffee itself is full of antioxidants, and it's one of the things that makes it so beneficial. It's just chock full of antioxidants that can help your body.
So is espresso better than coffee?
No, they're all
okay.
good.
All right.
Now, here's the bad side of
whipped
coffee.
Whipped cream on the top.
See, that's one of the things. Some people don't metabolize caffeine very well, and because of it, they get all the side effects of caffeine, which would be nervousness, shakiness, stomach irritability, upset. Sometimes if they have mood disorders like anxiety or depression, it'll make those worse.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And if they have heart trouble, they might not be able to tolerate caffeine. So if they're not drinking caffeine, it's a good idea that they don't start.
Okay.
And for people that want to get off of the caffeine, it's best to wean by about a cup a day. So if you're drinking, say, excessive amounts, like 5, 6, 10 cups a day.
Wow.
I used to do that when I was in the service. I drink 10 cups of coffee
that's
a day. And I used to shake like
coffee,
crazy.
Doctor.
And that's too much. Then you'll suffer from caffeine intoxication. So the best way is just wean by one cup a day till you finally get down to that 1 or 2 cups a day. And then switch over to something like green tea. Green tea does a great job of helping to detoxify the body and decrease the amount of caffeine that you have.
Because you start getting the headaches when you're decaffeine.
Yeah, you do. You get the headaches from it. That's why it's best just to slowly come down.
If
you've never had caffeine, it's probably best not to start, right?
You're right.
Like, you don't really care for coffee too much.
Yeah, I'm not a big coffee guy.
Yeah, and see, I wouldn't recommend that you start. But for people that are drinking too much, to bring it down a little bit.
I have one cup of coffee a day.
And one cup is fine.
That's all.
Yeah.
How many for you, Doc? How many?
I have usually about 2 to 3. And there's studies that show that 2 to 3 cups of coffee a day are about ideal to get the antioxidant capacity.
Oh, very. Okay, so
he's going to say that. He's the doc. He's going to say that.
I believe, Dr. Rob.
Well, I'm going to show you one of my tricks that I do. I actually like to drink espresso. And two of the things that I put in here to boost the antioxidant quality of my espresso is I like to put cinnamon in it.
That was just a little too much.
That's actually delicious.
And then I like to put nutmeg. And we talked about nutmeg before because it increases the blood flow to the sexual organs, so it can boost your sexual performance. So I have to applaud some of the coffee shops because they put nutmeg and cinnamon right on the shelf to put in your coffee.
Yeah, they do. I've never thought to use them.
Yep.
Mental
note. So now we should. Okay.
Yeah, good stuff. So all this information can be kind of confusing.
It is.
Should I drink coffee? Should I not drink coffee? Which way do I go? And let me share with you what my opinion is on this. If you've never started drinking coffee, don't. If you have trouble with coffee and caffeine and it's causing you all kinds of problems, definitely decrease it. And if you're drinking coffee and you have no side effects from it and it doesn't bother you, well, just keep it in moderation so you don't get in trouble. Because if you keep everything in moderation, it can't hurt you. Here are some of the kind of the drinks, coffee drinks, that can really get you into trouble. One of them's a frappuccino. And
this
the other
one's the bad side. This is the bad side, right?
Yeah, a caramel macchiato. And these have like 500 calories, 400 calories.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, so that's not a lot.
Okay,
so,
we got about 30 seconds left, Dr. Rob.
The way you look at it, if
bottom
you keep,
line,
if
don't,
you,
don't start.
If you keep it black and add some antioxidants, it has a lot of health benefits. And you know, sometimes it is a little good to be bad.
Oh!
Right?
Oh.
And then,
he
okay,
was
so
waiting
so
all
yeah.
day to
I was waiting
that.
All I was.
All right, Dr. Rob, thank you. Can I have one of these?
Yeah, absolutely. We'll get some out of these mocha pots.
Have one of these. All right, thank you very much, Dr.
Thanks,
Rob. Now, all week long, we've been asking you for your chili recipes, and it's time now to announce the winners of the chili cooking recipes. They're Roger Folk from Sydney and Amanda Stockman
from
Dayton.
We can applaud a little
round of applause
somebody.
To them.
Yeah,
yes, we're going to announce
fantastic.
The third winner
right
coming up later today on our Facebook page, so log on and check there. Now, all of the winners, we're going to have a chance to cook on the show next week. So we'll be in touch soon. We'll have you right here in the Living Dayton set, like Dr. Rob is doing right now.
Right, yeah.
But don't go